In today's tutorial, you'll learn three ways to apply textures without brushes in Adobe Illustrator, which you'll be able to use to texturize your illustrations even if you're a beginner. You're watching TNT Tutorials, let's begin! Copy needed object first and then apply a different color. Click on Window and select Transparency. You can drag Transparency panel here, this will be very handy. With copied layer selected, click on Make Mask. After this, click on Clip. Click on this window. After you'll do this, you'll enter Opacity Mask Mode. Press M for the rectangle tool and create a rectangle like this. Open Gradient panel. I recommend you to drag it somewhere here also when you're applying textures. With rectangle selected, choose Linear Gradient. You should have one white and one black slider. Now click on Effect, Texture, and select Grain. I will explain how to adjust these settings in different cases later in this video, so for now let's select Stippled. Play with sliders and click OK. Press G to use the gradient tool and move sliders to adjust noise better. To continue editing other objects, simply exit Opacity Mask Mode by clicking on this window. Make a copy and change a color for it. After this, click on Make Mask and then on Clip. Select this window to enter Opacity Mask Mode and create a big rectangle. In Gradient panel, choose Freeform Gradient. Each time you will see 4 points. We will need only 2 points to start. So with Points mode selected, it is selected here by default, pick 2 points and press Delete to delete them. You should have one white point and one black point. Simply double-click on them and change color. I will move white point down for now, select black point and then add more black points by clicking with the left mouse button only. Let's pick white point and duplicate it a few times also. After this, go to Effect, Texture, Grain, select Stippled again, play with values and click OK. To have better control on further manipulations, select Lines mode in Gradient panel, select first white point and connect it with other white points. To stop connecting, simply press Ctrl or Command. After this, connect black points. In Gradients panel, select Points mode again and adjust noise as you want. You can move points, add them by clicking on the lines between them, and delete them by pressing Delete button on your keyboard. Multi-layered textures are the best way to make even simple flat illustrations look very rich, live, and eye-catching. I'll show you a combination of three layers, which I use almost every time, but you can experiment and add even more layers. Here we go! Pick needed shape, make a copy, change color slightly. In Transparency panel, select Make Mask and click on Clip. Click on this window to enter Opacity Mask mode and create a rectangle. In Gradient panel, select Linear Gradient. Press G and drag Gradient tool like this. Double-click on this slider, select Grayscale and choose something like 95%. Do the same for this slider and choose 98% for example. Click on Effect, Texture, Grain and select Soft. Take a look at how graininess changes as I play with these settings. Let's stop on something like this and press OK. You can easily change texture color. Click on this window to exit Opacity Mask mode and adjust color. To edit texture, enter Opacity Mask mode again by clicking on this window, select a rectangle with texture, click on Properties and find Applied Effect. Play with values until you like what you see. We adjusted a first texture. Let's exit Opacity Mask mode and duplicate needed object again. Change color to something bright, make mask, clip, enter Opacity Mask mode, create a rectangle and select Freeform Gradient. Let's delete these 2 points and apply black and white colors to these 2 points. Place points as I showed you in second method, connect them and get something like this. We've created a rim light. In Grain panel, select Stippled. Try these values. They will allow us to spread grain all over the shape. Don't hesitate to play with freeform gradient and adjust it as you want. Don't forget to click on this little window to exit the opacity mask mode. Let's move on and create a shadow with slightly different settings. Repeat all steps with creating a copy, applying color, mask, and a freeform gradient, but this time simply pick darker color. Also, this time in settings, use these values. Grain won't spread and stay only in area of the shadow. If texture looks too rough, click on View, Document Raster Effect Settings. Try different values until you like what you see. Let me show you how huge the difference is and how it is important to play with these values. If you learned something new from this tutorial, drop a comment below, let me know if everything was clear enough for you and what you liked about this video. If you enjoyed this tutorial, support this channel by clicking on subscribe, and what's most important, by clicking on the bell icon to get notifications about newest tutorials from TNT. I'd also appreciate if you'll click thumbs up and will share this video. This was TNT Tutorials, see you in next videos!